my first question is how the refueling went last spring, because that's what brought this on. They shut it down and started the refueling. So that's one question for you. The next question for you is, since you put them on a special list and we have to, you have all this oversight now and you're spending all this time, I'm wondering, would this be the same process if we were shutting it down permanently? Would this be the exact same process that you guys would have to create a special commission and start working on it? I'm just curious. It feels like we're heading in that direction because we've already set up this extra work and paying for this extra work on federal level, local level, taxpayer level. So I'm just wondering if this is the same structure that we would use to actually just shut it down permanently.
If the facility chose to shut down and decommission, it's entirely different process on how to have a dismantle plant, put it in a safe store type condition, and eventually take it back to a greenfield type condition. That's a totally different arrangement and oversight program. It's done by a different office in our headquarters facility altogether. David, do you want to address the refueling?
As was stated, we never finished the refueling because of we had to stop those activities and then go into our procedures for protecting the site. And so the intent is that we would recommence those activities once we make sure that we have our performance issues corrected.
So were you halfway through it, a quarter of the way through it? How far were you? Was there stuff left out on the floor because you had to run out? You know, just curious.
No, we obviously everything was placed in a very safe condition, but we were 90% complete.